हेलो क्लास फाइव स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर वन एंड ऑल्सो डिड इंटीग्रेटेड लर्निंग. आई होप यू हैव डन दैट क्वेश्चन इन योर मैथ्स कॉपी. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट राइटिंग चैप्टर नंबर टू, रोमन न्यूमरल्स इन द नोटबुक. एज यू ऑल नो दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न दिस चैप्टर एंड प्रैक्टिस्ड एज वेल इन द रफ कॉपी. So, how will you start this chapter in the copy? Here are some tips. Put today's date, that is 16th May. Show classwork. Chapter number 2, Roman numerals as heading. And before going to the exercise, we will write some facts, rules and table. So, put a star, write facts. You will find this on page number 13. Okay? When you are writing from the video, you just pause it. And then write in your notebook as it is. Number one fact is the most commonly used number system is the Hindu-Arabic numeral system. Isn't it? Hindu-Arabic numeral system which uses the numbers 0 to 9. What are 0 to 9? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Second fact is the Roman numeral system which we are studying in chapter number 2 is one of the oldest numeral system and it is developed by the Romans. Third fact is this numeral system, that means this Roman numeral system is based on seven distinct means different symbols. And what are the symbols? The symbols are from the alphabets, letters. What are the letters? I, V, X, L, C, D and M. Only seven symbols are there in Roman numerals and they have different values as well. Number four is it uses, that means the Roman numeral system uses either one of the symbols. It uses either I, C. C means, you know, 100. I means 1. So this system either uses one of the symbol or combination of symbol. Okay, when you will go to class 6, you will write VI. So it's a combination of two symbol. And to write in Hindu-Arabic numeral system. Number five fact is, however, this system does not have any symbol to represent zero. Students, unlike in Hindu-Arabic numeral, we have a digit zero. But there is no particular symbol in Roman numeral to show zero. Okay? After that, I hope this will come in one page. You will go to the next page and write rules, which you will find it on page number 13, 14 and 15. How will you write it and what will you write it? I will show just now. Students, for writing the rules, you have to open your maths book, page number 1313. And then whatever I have underlined in this page, you are supposed to write it. What it is? Rules for writing Hindu-Arabic numbers using Roman numerals. Then you will write rule 1. A Roman number can be repeated only thrice in a row. That means XXX, CCC. Right? I. So, when it is repeated, its value gets added to obtain a final value. Now, some examples are given. Many examples are given. So, we are supposed to write only two examples for each rule. So, you will use the short form of example, that is EG colon, and whatever two examples are underlined, you are supposed to write them one after other. Okay? One example in one line, second example in second line. After that, turn the page, get the rule number 2. What it is? When a Roman number with a smaller value is written to the right or after a Roman number with a greater value, the value of both the numbers are added to get the final value. So, you are supposed to write the whole sentence. Example, these two are the example which I have underlined. What it is? VI. V is greater, I is smaller. I is coming to the right hand side of greater Roman numeral. So 5 plus 1, what it is? 6. So in the next class, you will go to this class. Okay, similarly, the next example. After that, rule number 3. When a Roman number with a smaller value is written to the left or before a Roman number with a greater value, the value of the smaller number is subtracted from the value of greater number to get the final value. For example, XL, X is 10, L is 50. 10 is smaller and it is written on the left left hand side of the bigger number. So x will get subtracted from L. What is L? L is 50 and x is 10. We will subtract them and get the value of 40. So xL is 40. So I have underlined two examples. Write it after rule number 3. After that, rule number 4, students, completely you will write what it is if 3 or more Roman numbers are written in a row such that smaller Roman number lies between the two greater Roman numbers, then the value of smaller number gets subtracted from the greater number lying to its right. Take an example, XIV. Here X is 10, I is 1, V is 5, right? So we will look at the smallest Roman number, that is 1. If 1 is written on the left hand side of a greater, we will subtract. So this I will not add it to this 10. Rather, this I will be subtracted from the next greater number. So that is how x is 10 plus IV is 5 minus 1, isn't it? IV 5 minus 1, 10 plus 4 is equals to 14. So this is how we write 14. What is 14? If you write the expanded form of 14, that is 10 plus 4. So first write 10 in the Roman numeral and then write 4. This is how you get the Roman numeral 14. Second example is also underlined. Now you have to come to the next page. Moving to the next page, the last rule lies, if a bar is placed over a symbol, then its value gets multiplied by 1000. Take an example, V bar. That means V is 5, bar means multiply by 1000. So it becomes 5000. Similarly, M bar, M is 1000, multiply by 1000. So count the number of zeros. 3 plus 3, that is 6. So the final result will have 6 zeros. So you may count, you will get 6 zeros. And it is read as 10 lakh, isn't it? Hope you have understood today's class. And students, after writing those rules, 5 rules with 2 examples each, you will take another page and note down this table. This is very important table, students. I have noted down from your class 4 maths book. I hope you may also refer that. So note it down in your maths copy, okay, in the third page. Hope you have understood. Have a great day. Bye-bye, students.